To prepare for the latest installment of Deadpool and Wolverine, I decided to binge watch the X-Men and Deadpool movies. I intentionally skipped Dark Phoenix and New Mutants, having heard enough to know they wouldn't be worth watching. Here's my ranking of the movies I revisited from least impressive to the absolute best. This is my own opinion. Don't get on my ass. Coming out the same year as Batman v Superman, I have never been more disappointed in my life. Apocalypse felt like a missed opportunity with lackluster character development and an underwhelming villain. Despite its potential, the film struggled with a bloated plot and underused characters, failing to capture the epic scale it aimed for. Even the visual effects, while impressive, couldn't save this disjointed storytelling and lack of emotional depth. Rewatching this film, I love the Japanese sequences, but the numerous slow scenes left me feeling a bit exhausted. I was a bit tired watching this. It had moments of brilliance, but overall it struggled to maintain a compelling pace. The exploration of Wolverine's vulnerability and humanity was a strong point, but the final act with its CGI-heavy climax felt out of place compared to the rest of the film's more grounded approach. The movie shines in its quieter moments, yet it falters when it tries to become a typical superhero blockbuster. And before I even go any further, I just want to say I enjoy all these movies. Like, I easily would watch 12 to 1 all again. That's a testament to how good the X-Men universe was. They're just not amazing. They're average. Only a smidge better than The Wolverine. It's a fun historical watch to see where superhero movies were at that time. This film introduced Hugh Jackman's amazing portrayal of Wolverine, setting the stage for future greatness. The ensemble cast, including Patrick Stewart and Ian McKellen, brought a sense of gravitas to the comic book material. While it may seem dated now, X-Men laid the groundwork for the modern superhero film, balancing character-driven storytelling with action-packed sequences. Surprisingly, really fun. I don't understand the hate. While it has its flaws, the action and character moments make it an enjoyable watch, even if it's not the strongest in the series. The movie attempted to tackle significant storylines like the Dark Phoenix saga and the mutant cure, though it struggled with balancing these ambitious plot lines. Despite its shortcomings, The Last Stand provides some memorable moments and solid performances and very fun action. One of the best X-Men movies that does not include Wolverine, the fresh cast and 1960s setting revitalized the franchise. If only they had maintained this level of quality in subsequent films. The dynamic between James McAvoy's Professor X and Michael Fassbender's Magneto added emotional depth and complexity to the story. The stylish direction and period setting gave First Class a unique charm, making it a standout entry that skillfully blended historical events with mutant lore. I am biased. One of the few movies I owned as a DVD as a kid by myself, I would watch it constantly. It's a guilty pleasure of mine. It technically brought us Deadpool, so don't hate the player. Hate the game. Liev Schreiber is also the best Sabretooth in my opinion. Despite its numerous flaws, including a poorly executed version of Deadpool, the film has a certain nostalgic appeal to me. The opening montage of Wolverine and Sabretooth fighting through various wars is obviously the highlight, showcasing the film's potential that wasn't fully realized, but I would love to watch this once a year. Great film. Breezes by with a solid storyline and fantastic character interactions. It's a classic example of how to do a superhero sequel right. The movie expanded on the themes of prejudice and acceptance, delivering a compelling narrative that resonated with audiences. Nightcrawler's attack on the White House remains one of the franchise's most memorable sequences. X2 managed to deepen the characters' relationships while delivering thrilling action, setting a high standard for future X-Men films. One of the best superhero movies on a rewatch, I docked it a bit lower, but it's still a great ensemble and amazing storyline, even with a crazy plot. It successfully merged the old and new X-Men cast in a thrilling adventure. The film's time travel plot allowed for creative storytelling, exploring alternate realities and character arcs in engaging ways. Despite its complexity, Days of Future Past managed to deliver a coherent and emotionally impactful narrative. I believe I like this a bit more than the first Deadpool, but it feels wrong to put it higher. The humor, action, and heart were all there, making it a worthy sequel that built upon the original success. The introduction of characters like Cable and Domino added fresh dynamics to the storyline. The film's irreverent tone and meta-humor were amplified, resulting in even more outrageous and hilarious moments. Deadpool 2 balances comedic elements with genuine emotional beats that made me cry. They always do in that movie. I've watched it numerous times, particularly in exploring Deadpool's personal loss and growth. I'll never forget seeing the leaked footage and knowing instantly that superhero films would change. I saw this opening night on Valentine's Day with my mom and stepdad, one of my favorite movie experiences ever. It might feel slow on rewatch, but it's so much fun and broke new ground for the genre. Ryan Reynolds' portrayal of Deadpool was pitch perfect, capturing the character's charm. The film's R-rated approach allowed for more creative freedom, resulting in a fresh and unapologetically unique superhero film that resonated with audiences and changed the history of the genre. Recency bias is a thing, folks, but having these two characters together feels so right. Everything works, including the gratuitous cameos, which surprisingly make them more important than any superhero flick has done before. Check out my full review to know my thoughts, but the film's blend of everything, including the action that they enhance, the humor that goes farther than I thought they would have, and the heartfelt moments that I didn't really think that were going to be in here, made it an instant classic. Seeing Hugh Jackman and Ryan Reynolds share the screen was a dream come true for fans, and the movie delivered on all fronts, from its intensive fight scenes to its unexpected character cameos. Because Deadpool and Wolverine is so recent, and as of writing this, I had just seen it a few hours ago, it feels right to put Logan here at number one. It's a brilliant piece of filmmaking that elevates the genre to new heights. It's Hugh Jackman's best performance and will always be one of the greatest comic book movies ever made. Logan's gritty and mature tone provided a fitting end to Wolverine's story, exploring themes of morality and redemption. The film's intimate and character-driven approach set it apart from other superhero movies, delivering a powerful and emotional resonant conclusion to Hugh Jackman's iconic portrayal of Wolverine. Which, Deadpool and Wolverine do have a more fun ending for Wolverine, but this is so good.
You should take a moment. Feel it. You still have time.
Binge watching the X-Men and Deadpool movies has been a nostalgic and enlightening journey. Each film, despite its flaws, contributed to the rich tapestry of mutant cinema. From the early days of X-Men to the groundbreaking Deadpool and emotionally charged Logan, this franchise has continually pushed the boundaries of the superhero genre. With Deadpool and Wolverine, the legacy continues to evolve, promising even more exciting and memorable adventures in the future. Tune in every Friday for new movie videos. Please like, share, and subscribe. Comment down below what other movies you would like me to do videos on. Thank you, Mom, for editing the scripts for my movie essays. I appreciate you. Till next time, thanks for watching. Catch you on the flip side.